Hi there.
In this video, we're going to learn to create a game poster on Canva, so let's get started. Those who don't know Canva, let me tell you that it's not an application like Photoshop or Illustrator. It's a designing website instead. In Canva, more than creating designs, you need to assemble the different elements of design to create a design. So basically, it has preset templates that you can use and then make necessary amendments to them. Or you can use a blank artboard and add ready-made elements to it to create designs. So out here, once you click more, you'll find other templates as well. And you can click the one you want and start the assembly. Since we need to create a poster, you can see that the dimensions of this poster is 594 by 420 millimeters. And it's a landscape poster. But what we are interested in is the portrait size. So don't worry, you see this option on the top right that says custom size. Click it and update your size. Now, since we want a portrait artboard, all we need to do is flip the dimension. So instead of 594 by 420 millimeters, I'm going to make it 420 by 594 millimeters. And the moment I click the Create New Design button, it opens the artboard on a different tab. That's the artboard we'll be working on. And unlike Illustrator, the area around the artboard is not the pasteboard, so you won't be able to place any elements outside of the artboard. To change the color of the artboard, let's click this color picker, and it shall reveal a variety of colors. So from here, let's pick this color by clicking it once. Since I need to place an element here, I'll click the Elements tab. Let's type in racing car and hit Enter. And it shall populate all the elements it has in its repository for racing car. To place an element onto the artboard, all you need to do is click it once and it shall be there. To move the element around, just click and move and it shall move freely. What I want to do is insert a frame. So with the Elements tab selected, let's type in frames and hit Enter. And you shall find frames of different shapes and sizes here. Let me pick this frame here. Now, for people who are coming from Illustrator or even Photoshop would know what clipping mask is, this frame is going to help me create that effect. I don't want to place this frame vertically, so let's rotate it. To rotate an element, all you need to do is you see this small circle under the frame. Just click and rotate it, and it shall rotate. And it will also show you the angle so that you could rotate it to a particular preset angle. To increase or decrease the size of the element, just click and drag one of the corner handles as illustrated, and it shall obey your command. Let's place it at the center of the artboard. By default, it has the smart guides on, so once the frame is in the center of the artboard, you'll be notified by these pink lines. Since our image is now hidden under the frame, let's click it to select it, and go to Position option on the top right, and select Forward. Now here comes the tricky part. If we click and move the image around, you will find that the frame is ready to take it in. But then the problem is that the image has rotated itself as well, which we don't want. By the way, this automatic rotation happened because we inserted the image into a rotated frame. So let's hit Command Z on a Mac or Control Z on a PC to undo the last action. Now we need to trick the frame in a way that it accepts our image and automatically matches the angle of the image to its own angle. And for that, let's rotate our image to minus 90 degree angle. Now, when we place it into the frame, you'll find it accepting the image perfectly. I think we need to change the angle of the frame a bit because I don't want it so slanted. Just click it once and rotate it, much like earlier. I think I'm happy with this setting. It's time to add the heading of our game, so let's head to the text tab and click one of the sample text to import it to the artboard. Double click the text and change it to GTR. Let's place it at the top left corner. I think if I match the angle of the text to the angle of the image, it would look better, so let's rotate the text. Perfect. Let's also drag a guide from the ruler on the left and drop it at the left edge of the text. Let's type the letter T, which is the shortcut to place text onto the artboard, and you shall find the text box appearing. Let's resize the text to 18 points, and also change the font to Poppins Medium. Let's drag the text handle to update the font size, and then rotate the text to match the angle of the frame. I'd like to also left-align the text to the guide I had dropped earlier. With the text still selected, let's go to Effects, and you can find a few style options, so you can pick anyone that suits your style. Now let's get back to Elements tab and type in Red Spot. Let's pick this one and reduce the size, and then place it at the bottom right corner. Now I need to place a logo on top of this red patch. So under Elements tab, let's type in EA Games. We've got a few options here, so let's pick this one. Go to the color picker and change the color of the logo to a shade of yellow. Let's resize the logo and place it on top of the patch. Let's add the age certification on the left, so let's type in white rectangle, and from the options, let's pick this one. Actually, let's stick to the black rectangle, and we can always put in white text on top of it. Let's rotate the rectangle to make it portrait, and then place it at the bottom left, aligning it to the left guide. I think we need to reduce the size of the rectangle as well, as it's too big. Let's hit T to bring in a text box and type in 18. Now change the color of the text white. Place the text on top of the black rectangle. Holding Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC, click and drag the text to make a copy of it. Now change the text to EA Sports. Let's change the font to Poppins Medium. Let's change the font size to 14 points. I guess it's too small, so let's click the plus button to increase the font size to about 25. Now place this text right under the text 18. Let's bring the digit down and copy the text at the bottom and place it on top of the digit. Now change the text to certified. Let's add a shape to our design. So let's go to the Elements tab and type in Shapes. I'm going to pick this shape and let's change the color of the shape to yellow. Now let's place it on the top right of the artboard. Let's go to the Text tab and let's pick this stylish text on the right. Double-click the text and change the text to 10% off. And we don't need two lines, and since it's a grouped element, let's click the ungroup option on the top right, and then delete the extra text. Now select the text and go to Effects, and make necessary changes to your text. I think I need to change the font color as well, so let me change it to black. Now let's reduce the size of the text using one of the handles on the corner and place it on top of the shape. Let's hit the letter T once again to bring in a text box and type in until 30 September 2021. Let's change the font size to 8 points and also change the letters to lower cases. Let's place it on top of the shape right under the text 10% off and then increase the size a bit. Now rotate this text to match the angle of this text to the 10% off text. Let's make a copy of this tiny text and change it to EA Games. And rotate it and then place it at the left of the guide. Now copy this text and rotate it and place it on the right. And change the text to Game Partner 2021. And adjust the position of this text as well. Since our design is ready, let's click this icon to download it. Let's change the file type to JPG. Let's max out the size and quality of our design and then hit download. Give it some time to process the design, and there you go. Our design is ready. So like I mentioned earlier, it's not a full-fledged designing software, but it can still do a pretty good job as far as designing is concerned. So do give it a try. Alright guys, that concludes our session. I hope you've enjoyed the video and have learned something new from it. So do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Until we meet again, goodbye and thanks for watching.